Hello friends, my name is Suyash and today we will perform the basic write properties for both analog and digital. In our last video, we have discussed about some basics of BACnet and why we have initiated this project on LabVIEW platform. We have also discussed about the BACnet device simulator and how to perform the BACnet read property on LabVIEW. So before initiating the actual task, let's talk about some basics of write properties. The write property services is used by a client that make user to modify the value of single specified property of a BACnet object. This services potentially allows the write access to any property of any object, whether have a BACnet defined object or not. To begin with the actual topics, let's open up the LabVIEW software. This is our LabVIEW VI, which I have splitted into two parts, front panel and block diagram. To start the communication with the BACnet device, whose command must be broadcast, whose service is used by a BACnet user to determine the device object identifier and network addresses, and some other properties of device which share the same internet network. The IAM services is used to respond to whose service request. However, the IAM service request may be issued at any point of time. It does not need to be preceded by the receipt of the whose service request. To capture the BACnet packets in LabVIEW, UDP user datagram protocol is required. The UDP source and destination port shall be set to XBAC0. If we convert the XBAC0 into decimal, then it will be 47808. Just like the who is an IAM palettes, we will place all the created libraries for the different services which is required to perform this task. This is our front panel where we can actually monitor the BACnet data. With the help of this panel, we can monitor the data as well as we can control it by changing the values. We will make some small arrangements so it will be clearly visible to us. Let's start the arranging the front panel. After arranging the whole VI, our block diagram will look like this. Now we can start our actual testing to see whether this VI is able to perform the read-write operation or not. Due to unavailability of actual BACnet device, we will use the BACnet device simulator, which will create the BACnet environment. Trial version of BACnet device simulator you can find on the link mentioned in description. This is the main window of BACnet device simulator looks like. Any BACnet device must contain device object. The device object defines a standardized object whose properties represent the externally visible characteristic of BACnet device. There shall be exactly one device object in each device. To create a device object, right-click on a BACnet network and select the BACnet device. You can change the device ID and its name as per your requirement. Now to create the different object, right-click on the device, then select the Add BACnet object. You can choose any object as per your requirement. In our case, we will perform the read operation, and also this time we will perform the write operation. Actual connection between BACnet simulator and LabVIEW VI will look like this. In this, BACnet simulator is running on small PC and LabVIEW on the big one, and both are connected with the red color Ethernet cable. Let's start the VI. After pressing the run button, VI will successfully fetch the different objects from simulated BACnet device running on different computer. Start button will initiate the actual operation, reading and writing the analog and digital input and outputs. As we can see, the captured data of analog input 1 is same as the BACnet simulator is sending. Same way, we will check the analog input 2. Now let's check the binary inputs. So our VI is able to successfully fetch the data from simulated device. Now we will check the analog outputs. Current value of analog output 1 is the same as it is showing into the simulated device. To change the value, enter some random value in right control palette, then after pressing the right button, it will reflect the value into the simulated device. As you can see that we are able to write the value over the BACnet communication. The same way we will perform the operation for rest of analog outputs, which is analog output 2 and analog output 3. Now this VI is able to perform the 3 analog outputs and 3 digital outputs, but it can be extended up to the limit to which BACnet standard permits. For the binary outputs, selecting the Boolean value after pressing the right button, it will reflect the same value on the BACnet device simulator. And as you can see that for the binary input, we are also able to write the data.
Same way we will perform for binary output 2 and binary output 3. As we can see that this LabVIEW VI is able to perform the BACnet communication without any help of external converter. And this time we have successfully performed the read operation as well as the write operation.
In our next video, we will perform the same operation for analog and digital values. For more information about the BACnet, you can visit my blog.